Good afternoon, and thank you all for being here to cover this press conference. I will speak, and then Bill Doran from FEMA will speak, and then we'll have Admiral Paul Thomas, who is the commander of the 8th District United States Coast Guard. He will speak today and introduce himself to the folks of Louisiana, and we appreciate his presence. President Trump approved a request that I made yesterday for a federal emergency declaration here in Louisiana. That declaration covers five parishes. They are Beauregard, Calcasieu, Cameron, Jefferson, Davis, and Vermilion parishes. Did speak with Brock Long, the administrator of FEMA, early this morning, where he confirmed that the president did sign the declaration upon our request. And obviously, if we need to and the situation warrants, we can add additional parishes to the declaration moving forward. And we do have a long way to go with this particular storm. As we told you all and the folks of Louisiana last week, this is going to play out over several days. That's exactly what's happening. The storm is more or less stationary, but to the extent that it's moving, it's actually moving towards the east in our direction. And that makes this obviously a dangerous situation for our state, especially those people on the western portion of our state. While the tropical storm has weakened, it does remain a named tropical storm, and it's going to drop an awful lot of rain. We believe going forward this will remain primarily a rain event, not a wind event from the storm, but there are a number of tornadoes that are developing as it relates to this storm as well. So please take those tornado watches and warnings very seriously. We do expect that the storm will drift slightly to the east over the next two or three days, and then will slowly move north and slightly towards the east, and somewhere around Toledo Bend, between Toledo Bend and Shreveport, it will cross over the state of Louisiana. Of course, it's going to drop a lot of rain the entire time, and as it moves further east, we can expect that those rain bands will also move further east. And so in all likelihood, the worst is yet to come for us in Louisiana. As you all know, we've had more than our fair share of afternoon thunderstorms throughout the summer, and so the rain had already saturated the ground before this event ever started. Specifically with respect to southwest Louisiana, through Friday, so by the end of this work week, they're anticipating a total of 10 to 15 inches of additional rain. In addition to that, the storm surge forecast, again, has gone back up a little bit to between 1 to 3 feet of storm surge above ground level. Now, where that impacts us the most, not just in the low-lying areas where that's enough to cover a road, but it will also prevent the rivers from draining the way we would want them to, so that that rainwater actually gets out of people's businesses and homes and off of their property and into the Gulf where we want it to go. There is an increased threat of tornadoes, as I mentioned, and there have been many suspected and confirmed around southwest Louisiana over the last several days. We look for that to continue. Cameron Parish remains under a mandatory evacuation south of Intercoastal Canal, and largely that's because of water that is overtopping roads. One of the things that I want to say again, and we say it in all of these natural disasters that relate, that result in flooding, please don't drive through any standing water if you don't know the depth and don't know for certain that it's safe for you to do so. That is a very dangerous thing to do, and we've seen that play out now in Texas, where that was responsible for at least one fatality over there as well. Speaking of Texas, we do have 40 members of the Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries responding to Texas with vessels pursuant to a request from Texas to assist in search and rescue. There was one team of 10 that was actually there yesterday, and they partnered up with their counterparts in Texas and effected 700 rescues yesterday. Last night, there were 20 individuals in a shelter in Repeats Parish. 8 of them had come from Texas, and so obviously we want to be the best neighbor that we can be to Texas, while at the same time we do what we have to make sure that we're prepared for this disaster as it unfolds in Louisiana and that we're able to take care of the folks here. And so we stand ready to provide additional assistance to Texas upon request moving forward. The National Guard continues to position assets across the state in preparation for the rain events that we expect to happen over the next several days. I'm asking the people of Louisiana to pay particular attention to this storm. Go to 511LA.org if you have any questions about road closures. That's 511LA.org to get the latest information on the emergency itself. Go to emergency.la.gov, emergency.la.gov. And then looking forward, both as it relates to Louisiana and perhaps primarily to Texas, I want people to go to volunteerlouisiana.gov. This is an effort that Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser, who is with us here today, will preside over as it relates to volunteer efforts to help with any disaster damage here in Louisiana, but also with respect to Texas. One of the things that we're hearing from our friends in Texas is that they are very much still in the response mode. They're still doing search and rescue. Now is not the time for people in an uncoordinated fashion to start sending things or driving into Texas because you can cause more of a problem than you will be of assistance over there. So we want to organize the efforts here in Louisiana. There will come a time in the next few days where they will transition from response to recovery, and they will need all of the things that are associated with the recovery. And we know that we want to be as generous as we can to help them in the way that they've helped us numerous times over the last 10 or 12 years. But Lieutenant Governor Nungesser will be heading up those efforts to try to make sure that we are responsive without causing problems for them in the process. There are a number of parishes with school closures today. I think there are 12. Some have already announced closures for tomorrow as well, so the people need to be paying attention to that as we move forward. There are state office closures in Vermilion and Jefferson, Davis, Vernon, Beauregard, and Allen, in addition to Cameron and Calcasieu. So at this point in time, I'm going to ask Bill Doran from FEMA to come up. He will be followed by Admiral Paul Thomas of the Coast Guard, and then I'll come back up to take questions from you, and you can certainly direct those questions to anyone who is here standing behind me as well.
Hey, thank you, Governor. Appreciate the partnership. As the Governor said, we have gotten an emergency declaration from the federal government. As FEMA and other federal agencies are supporting the state of Texas, we've remained focused on the state of Louisiana. The President approved an emergency declaration for the state of Louisiana support response efforts for Tropical Storm Harvey. The declaration makes available emergency protective measures in those parishes of Beauregard, Calcasieu, Cameron, Jefferson, Davis, and Vermilion, as well as the state of Louisiana supporting the state and local governments. FEMA's repositioned Regional Incident Management Assistance Team and has been here since August 23rd. Currently have personnel from FEMA, U.S. Coast Guard, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, U.S. Department of Defense on the ground in Louisiana supporting the state. State requested resources needs, including shelter commodities, meals, and medical needs commodities, have been prepositioned or on standby already here in the state. And FEMA has been working with state and local partners since August 14th with this threat. FEMA continues to support state and ongoing recovery efforts from the 2016 floods, and we appreciate the partnership we still have with that, which has also allowed me to have a pretty robust amount of folks here in the state already. We continue to follow instructions of the state and local and tribal officials as far as evacuations. Continue to listen to those local officials. They're the ones that know best their communities. Still a dangerous storm. Resident visitors are areas potentially affected by the severe weather. Should continue to monitor local radio and TV. And remember also we have our ready.gov online to get preparedness tips to folks out there. Thank you. Admiral.
Good afternoon. I'm Admiral Paul Thomas, the commander of the Coast Guard's 8th Coast Guard District, which is headquartered in New Orleans, serves the people of all the Gulf Coast states and the river systems. As you know, the Coast Guard's been very busy in Texas over the last few days supporting of federal response led by FEMA in response to the governor in that state. But we have not lost our focus on the state of Louisiana, and I'm here today to meet with the governor and his team to ensure that we are as prepared as possible to support when and if we are needed. The Coast Guard currently has 39 rotary wing and 7 fixed wing aircraft available for search and rescue response missions in Louisiana if needed. And we have 4 shallow water boat teams that are being pre-positioned to southwestern Louisiana today, again, to support the governor's team if needed. The good news is that our Coast Guard teams have a long history of operating with the response professionals here in Louisiana. We operate together, we practice together, and we're ready to serve this state together when the governor calls for us. Thank you.
Thank you, Admiral. And I do want to just finish up the prepared remarks by saying what a good relationship we've had with our federal partners from FEMA, with the Coast Guard, and all others. We've actually had FEMA folks here over the last several weeks as we've prepared for this particular storm, and the communication, the collaboration really has paid off tremendously, and we look forward to continue working with them as well. Yes, sir.
Governor, has there been any requests from the state of Texas or Houston to take any evacuation?
Yeah. No, and we have specifically made sure that they know through the director of the Texas Governor's Office of Homeland Security and Emergency Preparedness that we are prepared to accept folks from Texas in our shelters. I can tell you, going into the storm, their thoughts were that they would move their evacuees north, keep them in the state of Texas in their own shelters. If they change their mind about that, we will certainly be willing to shelter Texas residents in Louisiana. That request has not been made.
Are you readying some areas like Dixon or something like that, just
yeah,
in case?
Well, we wouldn't do it in South Louisiana, but we have shelters that are ready in North Louisiana, and the idea is that we would actually put them in the Shreveport area, because we think from transportation purposes it would be easier to get them across I-20 coming out of the Tyler area into Louisiana, and we have the facilities there. That's something that Secretary Marquita Walters of the Department of Children and Family Services is working on. Yes, ma'am.
You spoke about the need for a coordinated volunteer effort. We've seen a lot and heard a lot about the Cajun mm-hmm. mobilizing. I guess, have you gotten any word from Texas, or is there any direction that you've gotten?
No, well, we are working through our Department of Wildlife and Fisheries and Secretary Jack Montesay, who is talking directly to the individuals with the Cajun Navy that we know about, you know, because the Cajun Navy isn't, you know, there, it is somewhat organized, but then just about anybody who volunteers to go over and pull a boat behind them considers himself part of the Cajun Navy. What we know is that the routes into Texas, where they need the search and rescue, it's very hard to figure out exactly how to get where you're needed. And so coordinating just the route you're going to take to approach is very important. But when you get on the ground, they want you checking in so that they know who you are, where you're going, and they don't have a duplication of effort, and that you're not in the way. And so we have a lot of people in Louisiana who have tremendous experience, and they do an awful lot of good work. And they're in Texas now. And we're just trying to make sure that they get there and that they're employed in as useful a manner as possible. And so that's why we're working that through Jack Montesay.
Governor, are there any reports that have any flood damage homes in Louisiana?
Yeah, we do not have reports of flood damaged homes yet in Louisiana, but we do have streets that are impassable. Now, I have a hard time believing we have as many streets closed as we do without having some damage out there, but the damage reports thus far have not been significant as it relates to structures. But we do expect that's going to get worse over time as the rain continues to come over the next 3 days, especially. And when the storm actually does start to track north, that rain will fall in the same river system that then has to flow back south again. So we do think that is a likelihood going forward. Well, generally speaking, and I'll let General Curtis come up and answer specifically. But high water vehicles and vessels have been staged across Louisiana in the areas where we were expecting the most rainfall and the most flooding over the last several days. He continues to refine that, and especially as we look at potential flooding going north, starting Wednesday when that storm system starts to move in that direction. But those high water vehicles, those vessels, not just from the National Guard, but wildlife and fisheries, they still have 15 teams, so that's 150 vessels that are available just at wildlife and fisheries, almost that many more with the fire marshal's office as well. So we have significant assets here in Louisiana. But General Curtis, you want to come and talk about your staging?
Yes, sir. Thank you, Governor. Our focus really up until today has been southwest Louisiana. We have numerous high water vehicles and boats in that area. I can get those numbers for you. But also we've been focused in New Orleans based on if they get another rain inundation and the capacity of the pumps. So we have high water vehicles and boats staged there. What I directed the Guard to do this morning is to start positioning over the west boundary of Louisiana, up through Natchitoches, Alexandria, and on into Shreveport. So as the storm moves that way, we will have high water vehicles and people with boats in position, ready to respond to the local leadership's need.
Have you had to deploy any yet to get somebody out of the house?
We have not. Not that I'm aware of at this point. I know we had some soldiers with trucks and boats in Calcasieu that were waiting for the leadership in that area to tell them to move forward and start doing evacuations, but I'm not aware of any of at this point.
Have you received any requests from the governor of Texas to help mobilize some of your troops to supplement the 12,000 National Guard troops that are on duty in Texas?
Yeah. So I've been in contact with their adjutant general over the last 4 or 5 days. We speak very frequently. They have not asked us for specific assets because we need to keep them here in Louisiana in case we need to respond. But based on the experience that we've had since Katrina forward, we have been assisting them with some planning efforts to understand the magnitude of what's affecting the Houston area. I would tell you at the National Guard Bureau in D.C., we've been assisting them with some planning so that as we look at other states' capabilities outside of the two affected states, you know, what they may be able to bring forward. And so they're talking order of magnitude, you know, 10, 20, 30,000 soldiers with capabilities being able to come forward for the governor in Texas and for Governor Edwards if needed.
And you would expect some of our troops to eventually?
Yes, sir. If Louisiana is spared, when we're comfortable that we've made it through this, I've offered, the governor's offered the Louisiana Guard, anything that we have can move to Texas to assist them.
Have you activated any of the troops beyond
the full-timers? Yeah, so as we speak right now, we've got about 100 on state active duty. The governor's given us authority today to go up to 350. And then based on the threat of the storm, you know, we will increase or provide him recommendations of how we should increase and where we should stage them at as the storm unfolds and we understand the threat.
Yes, ma'am. Are they talking with all of you about door-to-door searches, ultimately, like was done in New Orleans after Katrina?
Yeah. I don't know that they've gotten into that detail yet. You know, the main thing is the big search and rescue, both air, which the Coast Guard is heavily engaged in right now. I think you will see more military assets out there, and then the high-water vehicles and boats to do the large-scale evacuation. And then you refine that. Once you get out of the extremist life-saving measures, then you get back into the door-to-door searches, you know, with fire departments, the National Guard, and other assets to do the markings, like you saw in Katrina, the house, you know, door-to-door searches. Yes, ma'am.
Hi, are we still less concerned about New Orleans and the pumping system and the...
Well, when you said less concerned?
Yeah,
well, look, it's the forecast for southeast Louisiana for the rest of the week is a total of somewhere between 5 and 10 inches of rain. The largest rainfall there is expected Wednesday, and it tapers off Thursday and Friday. At the same time, we do know that the pumping capacity and electric generation capacity is improving on a daily basis. And so we are concerned, but certainly not panicked about the situation in New Orleans. It's as of right now, we feel like things are well in hand. And of course, as the storm moves further to the east, those rain bands will move further to the east as well. Now, whether they get all the way to New Orleans, I mean, we certainly don't know. But that's part of that weekly forecast of rain that we can expect.
One last question.
Yes, sir.
All right. As far as, I mean, now we have the federal government offering its 75% of its national. How would you just describe now the relationship as it's continuing between the federal government as pertains to the Trump administration, namely, and yourself?
Well, it's been good throughout. We actually had the opportunity to have the FEMA administrator here within the last couple of weeks. And Tony Robinson, who is the FEMA Region 6 administrator here, for several days as well, so that we could have conversations about general preparedness and the way that we would work together. And I think it's paying dividends for us. The president certainly signed our request in a timely fashion. We submitted it last evening around 2100 hours, about 9 o'clock or so last night. And then by 7 o'clock this morning, I was talking to Administrator Brock Long, and he told me that it had been signed. So at this point in time, the relationship is good, the coordination is good, and we're very appreciative. Thank you all very much.